Hello. This is Mary Cachet again. You know, going on up to the level, see, I'm getting better, making myself feel better, because, you know what I'm saying, that was devastating what I seen, man. Just like I already seen, and I just, like, cried and stuff. I mean, that junk is, like, too, I just can't go into it. I mean, it's so, you know, sometimes things just go so deep that you just can't even, I mean, y'all know what it was, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't nothing real bad. It just was on TV tonight, and I was like, good Lord, what we brought was brought back to that. I guess that's why God's going to look back. You turn into a pill of salt. I mean, it was just devastating. And then in every inch, every person, in every area, everything that had to do with it, you know, it showed the true colors of it. And it just like, it was a lot of reality. And I was like, my mind was like, ooh, this is just, ooh, that, and that, ooh. I mean, I don't want to, you know what I'm saying, really, you know what I'm saying. Because I want to hurt people's feelings and bring them back to old times. But, you know, just use your imagination if you've seen something devastating that had happened. And then, you know what I'm saying, in the world. And, you know what I'm saying, and then bring it back on TV. And then you be like, oh, then you cry all over again from the situation. And you get them same feelings. And then you get mad for a minute. And then, you know, no, I don't want to get mad. Then you're like, oh. Predestination. So that's how I got to that point. But anyway, we're gonna pass that. I also like to talk about men speak, you know, called David, when he, you know, he had an army, you know what I'm saying? His army was men. He had an army. All his army was a men of valor. Men after God's own heart. Men after righteous and truth. You know what I'm saying? We got a lot of soldiers out there is after righteous and truth. And they are truly men of value. You know what I'm saying? That's why you got so many that you see that, you know, they just kind of upset a little bit because they feel like they didn't get paid. You know what I'm saying? That they not got to get that way. But just feel like, you know, just the world ain't looking. But actually, I see, you know what I'm saying? I feel like any man that lay his life down for somebody else, you know what I'm saying, should inherit the kingdom of heaven. If you really fit it in your heart and you good in your heart and you know, and you go at it like David in the Bible, and he's at thousands and thousands of men of valor. I mean, if I had the book right here, I could, you know, break it down to you. They might bring it back to you, but you can look it up yourself. You know what I'm saying? But he had all of them was after God. They had a new God, and when you know God, they want a lot. They was the strongest army that was ever laid. They had a strong army. I mean, it's just a story. You should really check the word out. It was the stories. But anyway, I just want to let you know that God is alive. And every day we must always humble ourselves, as we'll do, but humble ourselves at the end of the night and bend our knees and say our prayers. You know, it's in the Bible how you say your prayer. It's in Luke, Mark, and all that. You know what I'm saying? Heavenly Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give this day our daily bread, and forgive those that we are. You know the prayer. You know that's the prayer. And all that other stuff in vanity, all that access for cars and all that. I mean, you know, you're going to get that. You know, so you get that yourself. But, you know, you ask me, you shall receive. You shall receive what you ask for. You know, you'll get it anyway, whether he gives or not. But you get and say your prayer, humble yourself, and you feel good the next day because you say, because life today now is too, you know, it's too much for people that ain't ready for it, that's not ready for it, really. You really, you know what I'm saying? You need to, you know what I'm saying? That's why it's good to read the word, because when you read the word, it tell you so much deep stuff that, you know what I'm saying, you accept things, because all that is in Proverbs. I would love people to go out and look at Proverbs, because Proverbs will tell you that how to live, you know what I'm saying, and stuff, the instructions on how to live in this world. Because it's a mess of living in this world. People, you know what I'm saying, people want to go and stuff, they don't want to live no more, and I mean, they get to that point where they're just tired. So, on the contrary, what you know, saying I look at, you know, saying I look at it and say predestined. God laid the day out. Do I still love God today? Yes. Am I gonna seek God more than usual? Yes. Because if I stay out of the spirit, that's it. I'm back into the world, so I'm depressed again. So you can't go in and out and in and out, just like a little kid. You're in and out the door. You either go, like my mom used to always say, stay in or out. Don't keep going in and out. And that's how people do in the spirit. They go in the righteous spirit, then they come out of the righteous spirit. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, you just, it keeps you a double-minded person, unstable in all your ways. So we don't want to do that. Lord knows we don't. But predestinated, and thank you, you military people that, you know what I'm saying, that doing what you're doing, you know what I'm saying, you know, laying your life down. I salute you, you know. I salute you with everything. I bless you. I mean, God bless you and keep you, you know what I'm saying, because he bless you and he keep you. 26th Psalm should be for you, because you sign a paper saying, you know what I'm saying, that you would be in the military, that you would lay your life down for someone, that suffer for someone, so you shall inherit the kingdom of heaven. You will completely inherit it. You know what I'm saying? However, if you don't let that out of the spirit mentality come at you. See, if you're out of the spirit, you might can't understand. You probably might be suffering. But when you get in the spirit of God, God keeps you. Printed Psalm says, he said he'll lead you beside the still waters to restore your soul. But sometimes your soul, some things get down to your soul. You be like, oh, Lord, Jesus, oh, ooh. I just wish there was peace, Lord. Can we just, it's predestined, Lord, predestined. You told me that you laid these days out to be ready, read the Bible. And, you know, saying that's the only thing that's missing. A lot of people would not be as depressed if they just read the Bible. Just challenge yourself to read it. If you did nothing else, and you're like, I don't read all these books, but you ain't read the Bible. People tell you, oh, yes, I did. I read the Bible, child. I said, girl, if you read the Bible, you really wouldn't be at, you know what I'm saying, in that position. Because when you read the Bible, something happens. Something happens. So, you know, you're going to be wiser. You will understand a lot of things. So, you know, don't trip, you know what I'm saying? Don't actually get so depressed that, you know, that you know what I'm saying, look like, you know, stuff, gonna, you know, something bad gonna happen, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? But you read the Bible, things get more clearer to you, much more clearer, you know? But, you know what I'm saying? I just want people to challenge themselves. But, I mean, I struggle every day. We struggle. Everybody falls short of grace. Everybody have a fall short every day. That's why God, they want you to, he says, seek him all day, diligently, earnestly, steadily. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know what I'm saying, you got to. So I'm gonna sign off. This is Miracle Shea signing off. He's saying, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And I talk to you when I walk with you. And may God bless you. I love you. Bless you. Bless you. In the name of Christ Jesus. We pray. Amen.